Now, in this particular video today, I'm going to show you how to edit a less wig of these pictures. Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. I see a lot of photographers out there that do images, and for some reason they do all the editing, skin tone, retouching and all that, and they leave this less wig peeping. They leave all this because some of our ladies do hair extensions, some do the less wigs, and for some reason people tend to leave on this less wig, which looks very, 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 very bad. It looks very, it makes an image look very cheap. You don't want to make your images look very cheap, because if sincerely, if a client gives you all that money and you present to them images that look this cheap, man, it's not nice. It's not really, really, really good. This less looks very, very bad in an image. It looks so bad. Let's dive into this already. Now, how do we do this? Now, this is the first thing you have to do when you are, before you even do any kind of skin retouching, cleaning up the image. You first clean up these particular things. So how do we go about this? So you come here, create a new layer. We're going to rename this less, just for the sake of our less removal. You know, just like that. So the next thing you're going to do, you're just going to come and get your clone stamp. This one here, okay? So what you come here and say current layer and below. Make sure this is selected, okay? So we're going to come and reduce the flow here to something like 12. And then we are just going to come and do what? And get our clone stamp. And then we're going to press Alt on your keyboard to select skin tone, to select skin. And then we come and then begin painting over here. Just like that. Still, you come and do the same thing, and then because, man, at the end of the day, you want to amaze your clients. You want to give your customers something beautiful, something they can look at and feel beautiful about themselves, you know? Still, the same thing. And by the way, I have a Retouching Secrets Masterclass that is going on right now. If you're a photographer who wants to level up the quality and outlook of your final images, no matter the camera, the one thing you should be focusing on learning and mastering right now is high-end retouching. In the past 10 years, I've helped thousands of photographers like you kickstart their businesses, and I can tell you, high-end retouching is by far the most important skill and a new photographer can learn. It adds 10 times more value to an average image. And it is for this reason I've put together a masterclass called Retouching Secrets, where I teach you everything I've learned from retouching thousands of images for my portrait and commercial clients. Inside, you're going to discover the basics of high-end retouching, the tools you need. I will reveal to you the image assessment secrets to help you retouch any kind of photo, no matter the lighting. You will also get an overview of the color theory, an introduction to professional retouching techniques. Then after, I will show you over a dozen real-world examples where you will watch over my shoulder as I work on real client photos, and you will learn how to retouch the most common scenarios you are likely to come across. With these tools, techniques, and secrets in your hands, you will be able to create amazing high-end glamour images for your clients, no matter the camera you are currently using. So if you are ready to take your photography to the next granular level, click the link down here and get started right now. Welcome back. Let's continue. Just come in. Oops, sorry. Just like that. So for this particular close to the hairline, of course, I'll just come and get a smaller brush. Then just paint through like that. Until I have. That particular hairline. So I'll just come with the layer mask, with the layer adjustment layer, just click right next to that, and then get my brush and right click here, and then I just paint in so that I refine the particular edge even more. So we have these particular ones that are, you know, these ones can always be removed in the in when you're doing the full photo editing. But as of now, you just come and, you know, I just want it to blend in very well. And then do it. Let's look at the before and after, guys. Look at this. Yeah, this is, that's the before, that's the after. That's the before, that's the after. Now, that's how you remove that ugly mess that is brought in by wigs onto an image. Guys, do not leave that less there. It looks very, very cheap, and the picture turns out to look so, so fake. The fact that people are using hair extensions, not all hair people who do hair extensions do these things the right way. So I hope you've learned something in this particular video. I'll see you in the next video. If you want to know how I edit my high-end images and how I attract high-end paying clients into my photography business, click the first link in the description below and join the Retouching Secrets Masterclass right now. And I'll see you in the next one. And adios.